Assam's traditional woven handloom product gamosa, with its distinctive red border and floral motifs, has earned the geographical indication GI recognition. The product will now get legal protection to prevent its unauthorized use. The application for GI tag was filed by the Institute of Handicraft Development. South Africa's big clothing retailers have vowed to buy an additional 85 million units of clothes, shoes, and leather goods manufactured in the country over the next few years to boost the textile industry. This step in the clothing retail sector is likely to boost the acquisition of domestic goods from its present level of 44% to 65% by 2030. After the foundation stone laying ceremony held on November 15, Lenzing Group officially launched construction work in Thailand to build the world's largest lyocell production plant. The new plant will have a capacity of 100,000 tons per year and will help Lenzing meet strong demand for lyocell fibers and strengthen its market position for specialty fibers. The US-China trade war offers huge opportunities to Indian leather exporters to raise shipments to the United States, according to the Council of Leather Exports (CLE), whose chairman PR Akhil Ahmed recently said at the National Export Excellence Awards event in New Delhi that the sector's exports to the US grew by about 7% in the last 4 months. Sri Lanka's earnings from textiles and garments exports increased by 6.6% year-on-year to $4.186 billion in the first 9 months of 2019, according to the statistics released by Central Bank of Sri Lanka. Imports of textile and textile articles were up by 1.7% to $2.127 billion, while clothing and accessory imports fell 14.2% to $203.6 million during the 9-month period. Burberry's revenue increased by 5% on reported basis, 3% on CER, to €1,281 million in H1 for the 26 weeks ending September 2019. As compared to revenue of €1,220 in the same period last year. Gross profit of the company was €865 million in H1 2019 against €825 million in H1 2018, showing an increase of 5% on a reported basis. The global trade of raw silk has grown at a CAGR of 2.85% from $730.83 million in 2016 to $751.69 million in 2018. However, the total trade dropped by 1.49% in 2018 over the previous year and is expected to decline $706.58 million in 2021 with a drop of 6% from 2018, according to data from TexPro. This year's cotton crop production in Australia is going to be the lowest in a decade, Cotton Australia recently confirmed. With only a few cotton producers able to access water, primarily groundwater, to grow crops this summer, Cotton Australia estimates a cotton crop size of 750,000 bales, just 16% of the 4.6 million bales harvested 2 years ago. 82% of US shoppers report having left an apparel store without purchasing what they want, and when that happens, 23.4% head to a competitor, while 15% order the item online with the same retailer. According to findings of the State of Industry 2019 Apparel Store Customer Experience Survey conducted by analytics firm CB4.